Directing is like, you know, because I love to decorate and design things. So directing is such a great thing to do because you get to do all those things. I love, you know, costume design, production design. How is a set going to function, you know? How, you know, for Amy, I wanted her to be the feminine aspect of the film, the mental. And so I say, oh, she has this gorgeous red hair. So when she makes her first entrance, let's put a sconce to Roy Walker, you know, on the wall right there to justify this beautiful glow, her backlight. You know, that's the fun of it. It's not just.
But you know, that you are into design and building as well, and your other many talents, and in a way, because of the way you are able to envision and manifest and design, but you've designed your career and your life. You've built all this yourself. So when I asked at the beginning, how are you able to do this? That makes sense, that you're able to build, design, and see what is needed, and then if it's not happening, you fill that void yourself.
I
just take one question.
I try.
Hi, my name's Sarah. I'm a singer also. I'm over here.
Over there?
Over the...
Oh, everybody's over there.
Hi. I'm a singer also, and I really believe you made me a singer since I was a little girl. I just love you so much. But anyway, I was just wondering if when you were a young girl, if you had a barber, somebody like an idol, like that you just like thought.
Who did you look up to? Who was sort of like a mentor?
It was Johnny Mathis. Yeah, I just thought he was so beautiful with those dark eyes. I'll never forget seeing him on the Ed Sullivan Show when we first got a TV, you know, and he had this gorgeous instrument, and he was so soulful, and he seemed like he was in pain a bit. I'm always drawn to pain for some reason, but yeah, that was him.
One last question there, and then we'll wrap it up.
Hi, so I'm
curious. Well, it's good to have a man speak. It's great.
I'm glad I saw that one. But I'm not offended if I don't sound like it. So, Flora, I'm curious to know, you say that you wanted to be a classical actress, a classical actor, studying and playing Ibsen and Chekhov and Shakespearean roles. One of your dream roles was to be Juliet, of course, which I think you should totally still do.
You know what? Sarah Bernhardt played her at 74.
I'm curious to know if you still have those desires or wishes or miss those opportunities as you are now, or if the career that you've established has compensated for that in any way?
No, I still think I could see the opening. I couldn't get the writer I wanted to do a piece about Sarah Bernhardt because it was really basically to play those great roles. You know, she played Hamlet, she played L'Aiglon, the young Napoleon. In a sense, accidental. You know what I mean? She played those men's roles as well as Camille and all those kind of great roles. So I think about it, but it's so hard to get these things done today. You know? I mean, you have to... Because part of me says, I'm lazy. I'm also lazy. I like to do nothing. I like to garden. That's what I was doing the last few days before I came here. You know, placing... plants, redesigning something in all white.
Always building, always designing,
always
creating.
Yeah. And be left alone because it's hard to be in the limelight. I don't really like stardom. You have to understand that. I really don't like it and what comes with it. And I don't like all that. Some people do. Some people really like that. I'm not one of them. So. I don't know what I'll do next.
Well, you show no signs of stopping, ever. We just saw her show. It was so funny. My parents, I asked, do you mind if my mom meets you backstage? She says, well, I hope I have a voice left after the show. Okay, well, she'll do all the talking, don't worry. For the show, And she just gave a magnificent concert. We go in the back, I figured she would just shake my mom's hand. Oh no, she invites us into the dressing room. She's got curtains up, a film crew. She sat and interviewed my parents for 45 minutes after.
Because I can't believe somebody has 10 children.
It was like she had an attraction. Barbara After Hours. It was amazing. Like, I mean, she could be broadcasting that show.
That was so sweet.
I was so amazed. You just don't show any signs of stopping. Icon, legend, inspiration, one of the most important people.